Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, hallowed be thy name. On earth as it is in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Give us this day our daily bread, hallowed be thy name. Forgive us all our trespasses, hallowed be thy name. As we forgive those who trespass against us, hallowed be thy name. And lead us not into temptation, hallowed be thy name. But deliver us from all the deceivers, hallowed be thy name. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, hallowed be thy name. Forever and forever and ever, hallowed be thy name.
Mahakayani Chala Viralum प्रथमेशनिश्चलवीरुवाम् महाकायनिश्चलवीरलोम् प्रथमेशनिश्चलवीरुवाम् विधविधमोदकलाडुगळिन्द निन्ननु वलिसुव परियेनो मूषकराजने निन्नात्मां विघ्नराजने परमात्मा लंबोधरानीनगलुं गणश्रेष्ठनीनगुतिरुवां लंबोधरानीनगलुं
Morning, my name is Gauri Mahato from 2nd POC C-section. Thought for the day. Struggling will make you stronger. Once upon a time, a man found a butterfly that was starting to hatch from its cocoon. He sat down and watched the butterfly for hours as it struggled to force itself through a tiny hole. Then it suddenly stopped making progress and looked like it was stuck. Therefore, the man decided to help the butterfly out. He took a pair of scissors and cut off the remaining bit of the cocoon. The butterfly then emerged easily, although it had a swollen body and small, shriveled wings. The man thought nothing of it, and he sat there waiting for the wings to enlarge to support the butterfly. However, that never happened. The butterfly spent the rest of its life unable to fly, crawling around with the small wings and a swollen body. Despite the man's kind heart, he didn't understand that the restricting cocoon and the struggle needed by the butterfly to get itself through the small hole were God's way of forcing fluid from the body of the butterfly into its wing to prepare itself for the flying once it was free. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, parents and students and dear teachers. It's good to once again reconnect to you all. Every Friday, we will be having assembly and we appreciate the students who are involved and take part in conducting the assembly. It was also nice to see all the 2nd PUC parents attend the meeting. It shows the interest and the concern that you have for your child. I think by now all of you have installed the Parent Eye app. If not, and if you need help, please visit the college so that you will be able to understand the various features. It's a reminder also for all of you that the last day for paying up fees is 13th August, which will confirm your admission to 2nd PUC. Class test marks of certain subjects which were conducted in this week are already posted. So you will be getting to see the marks in the parent eye when you go to the option of class test. So kindly have a look at the marks of your children to have an idea how well they have performed in the class test. And if they haven't performed well, let us encourage them to do better next time. But it is good for you all to understand that you need to do well in every test and exam. As I told you, the department on 4th of August has sent a detailed circular on how the whole year is divided into four parts and how examinations and their marks will be taken into consideration for your final marks. We will be sharing with you all soon. But just to remind you all, every test and exam will be taken into consideration, including assignments. We will share the circular with you all soon. This is about it. More interaction will continue in parent eye. Please keep checking whenever it is possible at the end of the day, just to know what is happening in your child's life, academic life. And you students, take care of yourselves. Continue to consistently prepare yourselves for the board examinations. Things will be easier for you all if you make it a regular practice to learn whatever is taught in the class on a regular basis. Have a good day, and also see you next Friday. Thank you.